Welcome to Tokyosaurus. So what's up in Japan? Yesterday was an exciting day as we got a worldwide simultaneous movie release with Japan in the form of Blame. It isn't every day that we get simultaneous movie releases, and with the ease of access and the tons of subtitles slash audio options that come with Netflix distribution, this is definitely something worth welcoming in my books. But even with all these perks, it wouldn't matter if Blame wasn't good. So is it any good? We're gonna try to keep this as spoilers free as possible, but if you're the type to not want to get any information about a movie before you watch it, then maybe you should come back after you've watched it. So Blame started off as a manga series almost 20 years ago, back in 1998, and went on for about 10 volumes with 66 chapters. The manga was finished in 2003, and between today and back then, there were only a few short animations that were made, never a full series or a movie. This is the very first time that the series got a serious animated adaptation. Basically, this puts the viewers into two groups, ones that have read the manga, and ones that are completely new to the series. I am in the latter group. I have not read the manga, so I came into the movie having only watched the trailer. As with many anime movies that get adapted from manga, there is no way it can cover the entire plot. That is why we see so many anime movies that get divided into many parts. It's just how some anime movies work. They don't function as one-off kind of deals. You can't expect the whole package in 2 hours because there's just too much material to cover. In Blame's case, this movie basically serves as an introduction to Blame's world. And if there's one thing the series is good at, or probably the thing they are most famous for, it is in the world building. They don't give you much context, there isn't much of a script, hell, the main character barely has any lines in the movie just like the manga. But somehow they're able to draw you in from the very first moments of the film, get you curious about the world and the people that inhabit it. The 3D rendered style of animation is still something new to the anime world, as we've only seen it done well in a few other anime before like Knights of Cydonia or Ajin. But in Blame, especially with a movie budget, you can really tell where this art style excels in: action sequences. The fight scenes look absolutely mind-blowing, and the amount of detail in the clothing that people wear or the weapons people are holding is something that only 3D rendered characters can do. I am personally a big fan of Polygon Pictures' style of animation, so even if you're not in that camp, know that you're getting a much more polished version of that style in Blame. We don't get too much of a story in this movie, and we don't even learn that much about the inner workings of this unique world, but after watching it, I am definitely going to read the entire manga series now. I think if we go into the movie thinking it's a very long anime episode, it makes much more sense. Even the cuts between sequences are reminiscent of pacing from a typical anime episode. Blame definitely has the potential to get sequels, and I think Netflix is probably gonna decide that based on the viewership of this movie. So if you're into post-apocalyptic sci-fi with a very unique world, you definitely don't want to miss out on Blame. And if you're a fan of the manga wondering why the manga is so much better, do realize that the point of this movie wasn't to cover the whole manga, or even a big part of it. Its purpose is to introduce people to the series, so you should be happy that Blame is gonna get a big surge of readers, which can potentially get more products to be made. So all in all, Blame is definitely worth your time. Go watch it now so your life will be complete. Anyways, have you watched Blame yet? And if you did, what did you think of the movie? As usual, let me know down in the comments below. Thumbs up the video if you liked it, and don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications for Tokyosaurus for the latest things people are talking about in Japan. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.